What a dreary and raw day it has been across the valley. Hopefully your day has still been good so far. Maybe you've been productive indoors. I'm meteorologist TJ Springer here in the News 8 Storm Team Weather Center for an update because of the Derby. That's the big story on WGAL right now. Hopefully you'll catch this update maybe on the app or on WGAL.com. The rain, that's been the big story today, and you can still see numerous showers here across the Commonwealth, inbound too from the west, and you can see more across portions of Ohio and West Virginia. That's all compliments of a warm front drifting our way. The cold front still out to our west, slicing through portions of Illinois, back through Missouri, Arkansas, and Oklahoma. Eventually, that makes its way into the valley tomorrow night into early Monday morning. We can see the gloominess in the capital city, some drops on the Skycam lens right now as we're taking that live glance off to the north and west, seeing that low cloud deck. So if you are getting out, you'll certainly want to grab the umbrella this evening. The other big headline is that onshore flow keeping temperatures a lot cooler than where we were 24 hours ago and much chillier than earlier on in the week when we had temps in the 80s and 90s. We're over 20 degrees cooler in Lewistown comparing this time to yesterday on our Friday. Minus 11 in Lancaster, 15 degrees cooler there in Harrisburg and Lebanon with temps stuck in the low to mid 50s. This is pretty much where we've been all day long and where we're going to stay through the rest of the evening. Lower to middle 50s, numerous showers on the News 8 Storm Team forecast. Same story through the overnight. We start to see that rain pick up in intensity a bit as more of that widespread rain sweeps eastbound, upper 40s and lower 50s for our overnight lows. And tomorrow, as that warm front continues to work eastbound, we'll have widespread rain tapering to showers later in the day. A little drier by evening. I still think we'll have some lingering showers, though. It's still going to be damp and still going to be cool with highs right around 60. The one plus, though, with the moisture, it has knocked down our pollen levels a heck of a lot. Oak, birch, and maple are the contributing factors, but we're in the low category with moisture. Mold levels are in the moderate category. Also, with the lack of sun, no issues with the UV index, that burn time at an hour or longer. Here's predictor. We can see the showers lifting in from the west-southwest, and that's the story through the remainder of the evening, right through the wee hours of our Sunday. Maybe you have some plans for breakfast or brunch on our Cinco de Mayo. You'll definitely want to grab the umbrella and the rain gear once again. The steady rain continuing to work off toward the east through the latter half of the afternoon. You can still see some showers, but because of that cold front getting closer to us, the wind's starting to change direction, especially aloft. So between that, we'll be able to mix a little bit, I think, get some of the clouds to try to thin at least a touch. Here's predictor in terms of our rainfall accumulation. Still going to add another 3/4 of an inch to maybe an inch in some spots to get in on some heavier rains and downpours embedded in this activity as it works through the region over the next 12 to 24 hours. Not the greatest day to be out at the Art Walk. Sadly, it wasn't today. Same story tomorrow. It's from noon to 4. As long as you bring the rain gear, hopefully that art will boost your spirit, especially if you're bouncing around at these galleries. You'll be indoors, I'm thinking, right around 60 with hit or miss showers by 4. We stay unsettled. Isolated showers, some storms possible maybe on Monday. Tuesday, we're watching out for isolated showers and rumbles as a warm front starts to lift our way. Wednesday, ahead of the cold front, we'll have some lift, so we're expecting scattered showers and storms, some of which maybe on the severe side. That's something we're going to have to monitor. So please make sure you stay tuned for our latest. Our News 8 Storm Team 10-day features a big boost in temperatures, though, as we start to get some upper ridging back into the middle 80s. That fuels the instability, fuels the threat of storms on Wednesday. Thursday, as that cold front sweeps in, it'll knock our temps back into the lower 70s with some chances for thunder showers on Friday. Mother's Day may have to combat a couple showers as well, but overall it's looking a little drier, a little warmer. We're back into the lower 70s by early next week. It's going to be unsettled, so you want to keep the umbrella and make sure you have the News 8 app downloaded because you can have that radar in the palm of your hand. Have a great evening, and we'll have the latest coming up on News 8 at 11.